What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. And if you haven't guessed by the title, it is race day again, and we are back on the road bike, which is all clean and ready to race. Now, last week, we're racing at the same course that I raced at last week, which is the Bovingdon Bombers circuit. And admittedly, I got my ass well and truly handed to me. 5 minutes, see ya out the back. So this is a redemption day. I'm going to try and redeem myself. And rather than shying away from a course that I could be like moping about, like, ah, this course isn't for me, I want to try and be a rider that can like adapt to each course and not just cherry pick the ones that I'm good at. Yeah, I still haven't found one that I'm good at. Hopefully I can redeem myself after last week. I don't want to call this Project Don't Get Dropped, but it is what it is. But I've been listening to a podcast and they say, if you think you're going to get dropped or you're saying that in your head, it's normally what happens. So I'm going to call it Project Balls to the Wall or something. And I'm just going to prepare myself for like the start of a Zwift race and go absolutely balls out and cling on for dear life.
What's up, guys?
Just mugged me off. Race nutrition about to go down. Oh, big man mugging me off is going to be on the camera tonight. What are your tips tonight, Dad?
I'm not allowed to do trolling anymore, so I've got to stay quiet on the camera.
No, we're allowed. He's allowed to do his commentary, but last week I scrapped it all out because he just mugged me off for an hour. He said, hopefully we'll be able to lever our heads up this week, but this is going to go down and I'm hoping my legs feel good tonight. It's not windy though. I said, that's going to be a benefit, isn't it, for me? What'd you say? He's not hopeful. He's not filling me with confidence.
You rode like you had stabilizers on your bike on the last corner. It was just embarrassing going around the corner that slow.
It was wet. It was wet.
What's up, guys? It's Giorgio's dad on the camera. Officially, I've been told that I am allowed to troll and do commentary. Last week's commentary was scrapped because unfortunately protocol doesn't allow. And anyway, there goes Giorgio sitting in fourth position there. Let's just hope he goes around that corner down there and takes the stabilizers off the bike. That should help this week. Anyway, we'll see how he gets on. They're all lined up over there, getting the final pre-race chat about what to do, what not to do, and a few of them just undoing the stabilizers to get rid of them, to get around the corner a bit quicker. So hopefully last weekend we had to go out with our heads held low and make sure that nobody could see who we were. But let's hope that he does a better job this week. Right, so here we go then. This is the start of the world champ. There he goes. So that's the start of the first lap. We've been chatting about tactics and things like that, how he can improve. And one of the big things I did notice with him last week is he doesn't like going out down on the drops. If you're going to go down on the drops, now is the time you should be down on the drops. And then looking at all of the other guys that are leading the front there, all on the drops. So if you want to save yourself a few watts of power. But anyway, first lap, everyone's in one piece. Few starting to fall off the back already. And if I was racing, that's probably where I would be. I've had to do an emergency camera on here because he's decided to take the front down on the drops. Yeah, nice, nice. So he means business tonight. Yeah, he's still slow around that corner. Terribly slow. Dear me, my gran can go around there quicker than that, and she only had a whole 3-speed rally. Right, so a couple of guys, big efforts gone in there. Giorgio's fallen off the back, but he needs to stay with it because they could sit up. Stay with it in case they sit up and you can get back on. So I must admit, I've been out training with Giorgio and he can put some watts down. So God knows what those boys for fourth cats, what they're eating, God only knows. must be a huge amount of power going through there. But anyway, told them to try and hang on because hopefully they might sit up. They're starting to string out a little bit like that, and then everyone's going to start realizing they're all actually having to do a little bit of their own work and they're not drafting. So, you know, it is a fast pace, to be fair to him. Okay, work hard and get back on it. Go with him. So, yeah. So it's really important not to give up now and to stay with it, and then just hang on to the back of that group if he can. You just got to see someone's going again, look, to stop them getting back on. So he's just kicked off on the front there to pull them away from this little group here. Now you don't want them, but he's gone too hard, too big a gap, so he's time trial on his own. And hopefully, if Giorgio just sticks in there a little bit longer, he's falling off the back again. Not the way to do it, and I'm not sure he's going to get back on from there. Desperately got to get on the back here, so we need a big up. They're sitting up and they're talking. So let's have a look. Okay, get on the back of that. They're sat up now. Get on the back. So he's working really hard, trying to get himself back, and if he can get into the back of that, which he's just about pedal to get on, that's it, he's made it back. Brilliant job, great effort. Now you've just got to recover like Billy-O. Just heard coming through, the guys at the front there just got a bit excited and they're just saying, let's just pull it back. All of them probably really uncomfortable there, apart from maybe one or two of them. So just coming around, here's the leader. This guy won it last week. He's a real bit of an animal, this guy. You can actually hear, he really does have some power. And you can actually hear his tires screaming under the power he puts through. And this is the time to recover. So when they all sit up, look, guy here that can really tank it, he's sitting up, having a little rest. Tucked in behind Giorgio there. Just a little bit of an emergency news flash here. Keep on turning the camera off. He's sitting up at the front there. They'll probably pounce him and do some work there. Don't do too much on the front. And with all these races, you get them all shouting and egging you on to do a little bit, and they just sit there and do nothing themselves until the last lap. But fair play to him. He's at the front. He's giving it a good go. And it's the only way to learn. But this is when the attacks are coming through. Like now, the guy's starting to wind it up. He's attacking, so he's gone. And Giorgio really needs to be on that now, and he's just left it too late. See the gap already, like fifth place already. And he needs to get on that back wheel straight away. And he's just falling back down through the field so quickly. Much better than last week. Looks much better than last week. And that's all it's going to be. It's just getting that confidence, though, that you can do that and ride at that speed without blowing your biscuits. Again, we're about probably halfway. He's doing a really great job today, actually. He's at the front again. But a big attack's going to come in a couple of laps from now. So he's got to be really careful. Cover the attacks! And so fair play to him. I think really lucky, both my boys, never frightened to go off the front. So I really do take my hat off to them. They don't sit in the back there and let everybody else do the work. I'm really impressed with this bottom corner now. He's getting used to it. And then look, he's going straight there, keeping his speed, everything, staying with him and moving through on that corner now. And that's much, much better. So big attack going off now. Big attack going off now. And don't want to be going with that one. You want to leave that. He's looking behind already. Giorgio's doing the right thing, he's just letting him go. I think he's going to come back. I can't see him going. There you see, look, the pace is really starting to go up now. And
Giorgio was sitting right at the back and desperately needs to move up. Stay with it, stay with it. Now he needs to really dig there, because that's just too, that's it, he's doing it, it's absolutely spot on. Oh wow, that was the checkered flag, so the boy's done good. The boy's done very, very good. That was the checkered flag and he stayed in. Just walking over to see Giorgio, give him congrats. Probably more importantly, I know probably everybody wants to see Sarah on the cam, but unfortunately you got me. But also more importantly is the ladies are now racing. So there you are, there are the ladies. Going round, warming up. Here's the boy himself. Well done, nice job. Okay, obviously we don't have to wait for nightfall. We'll be able to go home in the daylight with our heads held high. So there's a bonus, we're going to be home early tonight. Here he is. Hey, we don't have to wait for nightfall today, then we can go home during the daylight. How was that?
Better, I was better on my drops, wasn't I?
Yeah, you were, yeah, well done.
My worst bit was when I was doing a turn on the front and then someone attacked me.
Yeah, I did.
I couldn't get back.
See that.
Like, but no one wanted to take the front and you're there and you're like,
gotta do it. Well, nothing wrong with that. Actually, if you listen to the recording, I did say we're proud of my boys that they're never frightened to go off the front. So
and as soon as I wanted someone to take over, I'd get attacked and I couldn't. Did you see I was dropping right to the back?
Yeah, I saw that, yeah.
3 laps to go, I was on the front. And then someone attacked, and on the final lap, I was right at the back, wasn't I?
Yeah.
And I couldn't make, like, the speed they were going.
That's a great effort, though, from last week, isn't it? Totally different race. You did have me worried at the beginning.
Oh, it's the first 5 minutes.
Yeah.
My legs don't get going.
Yeah.
They just absolutely nail it from the start. And then after 5 minutes, it settles down a bit.
Yeah.
And then I can...
I did hear them saying after that first 5 minutes, they all had a little meeting at the front to calm it down a bit.
Yeah.
But right. Yeah, well done. It's a good effort.
Much better than last week.
Yeah, so you've earned your Haribos tonight. Yeah.
And that is a wrap on race day. Super happy to stay with the bunch this week. Slightly concerned at the beginning. I'm really not used to that first 5 minutes. It is absolutely balls to the wall. So that is something I need to work on. And just my general power on the flats just isn't good enough to compete with these guys, but happy to dig in, stay in there, and stay with the front group. This is a huge improvement for me, and I feel pretty proud of myself for digging in, getting back on, and staying in the group. Shout out to the old man, he pretty much filmed the full 32 minute race and commentated on the whole thing. I haven't been able to put it all in, but I've done as much as I can, just so you're not watching a full 32 minute race of me and the old man commentating. Watch out GCN, he's coming for the commentary role. But that is a wrap. I hope you enjoyed the video. It's progress for me, I'm super pleased, and on to the next one. Got another crit this weekend, so hopefully I've got good legs and can start putting in some better efforts and start competing a little bit more. So I'll catch you in the next video.